If you have some free time, whether you're on your own or looking for something to keep everyone in your family entertained, you're probably going to skim Netflix. Hey everyone, this is Sam here from Best 10 Vids. In today's video, we're going to take a look over the top 10 Netflix series released in 2021. So let's dig right into it. Number 10, Shadow and Bone. Shadow and Bone is equal parts grandiose fantasy saga and riveting teen drama. The program focuses on Leigh Bardugo's popular books and follows teenage Alina Starkov, Jessie Mae Lee, a poor cartographer in Ravka's First Army. A perilous trek into the Shadow Fold reveals that Alina possesses the power to save her world for all time. She is a sun summoner. This discovery, however, instead of making Alina feel special, marks her as a target. While she is fighting foes from all sides, she is also being pursued by a group of seductive thieves. And don't even get us started on Alina's love life. Shadow and Bone is the type of fantasy epic that will take your breath away. Number 9, Midnight Mass. The creator of The Haunting of Hill House and Bly Manor returns with another slow-burning horror series that will haunt you for days. Mike Flanagan's latest brainchild, Midnight Mass, is a beautifully designed mystery that spans 7 hour-long episodes. Riley Flynn, who was still suffering the price for a drunk driving accident 4 years ago, comes home to Crockett Island, where the advent of a dynamic new priest coincides with amazing miracles all across town. Midnight Mass, filled with foreboding and dread, is an insightful inquiry of faith, complete with horrific supernatural monsters. Number 8. Sweet Tooth. This fantasy based on Jeff Lemire's comic book is weird and wonderful. Sweet Tooth features Gus, a fantastic Christian convery, a half-deer, half-human youngster who lives in the jungle with his father Pooba, Will Forte. The events surrounding the Great Crumble, a viral pandemic, drag Gus into a journey that takes him down intriguing, action-packed, and immensely amusing roads. In the treetops of this rich, compelling fictional realm, there are echoes of real-world battles. Fans of the genre should buckle up for this thrilling trip. Number 7, Cowboy Bebop. Netflix's brand new live-action version of the blockbuster anime series has taken some criticism since its November premiere. But the original program remains a fantastic, fabulously creative piece of entertainment and is accessible to watch in its entirety on the streamer. The show follows a motley crew consisting of an ex-hitman, a former cop, a scam artist, a hacker, and a data dog as they travel the galaxy in their starship, the Bebop, bringing in criminals for pay. The series, set in 2071, is famous for seamlessly blending numerous prominent film genres, including sci-fi, western, and neo-noir, to create something entirely original, confronting issues such as loneliness and leaving the past. It ran for only 26 episodes, but has since earned a reputation as one of the best animes of all time, with a worldwide fan base. Number 6, Lupin. Hassan Diop is played by Omar Sy, who is essentially a French Bruce Wayne if Batman was more of a cat burglar than a Dark Knight. Inspired on the legendary French figure Arsène Lupin, known as the Gentleman Burglar, Diop begins the series by attempting to steal a valuable necklace from the Louvre as part of a revenge plot against the wealthy family responsible for his father's death several years ago. Sy is a pleasant dude, and the heists and tricks are enjoyable, sophisticated acts executed while seeming to be the good guy. It's hardly the best show Netflix has ever produced, but it's a fun distraction that's easy to get through. Number 5, Inside Job. Recent events and the rise of social media have made conspiracy theories more common and strong than ever. So it's refreshing to watch a sitcom try to find the humorous side of things. Inside Job follows the staff of the shadowy government organization Cognito, where it turns out that every theory, from lizard people to JFK's assassination to robot presidents, is real. And it's up to anti-social genius Reagan Ridley and her co-workers to keep them hidden. Cue a workplace comedy unlike any other, with nearly every conspiracy theory imaginable getting a humorous explanation or witty reference. Inside Job is an odd mix of Rick and Morty, Men in Black, and The Office. It is created by Alex Hirsch, the creator of cult favorite Gravity Falls, and it surely retains the weird humor of his past ventures. Inside Job, thankfully, expands on its intriguing idea with whip-smart and frequently sarcastic humor, sharp satire of real-world concerns, and distinctively eccentric characters, including a clever parody of the lonely suffering genius stereotype. The Inside Job cast, which includes Lizzie Kaplan, Christian Slater from Mr. Robot, and Clark Duke from The Office, does an excellent job as well. Number 4. Young Royals. If you regularly find yourself scrolling through the Royalty AU category on fanfiction site Archive of Our Own, then Young Royals is the series for you. The Swedish drama depicts Prince Wilhelm, Edvin Riding, the youngest member of Sweden's royal family, who was sent to a famous boarding school after a public relations disaster marred his reputation. He meets Simon, Omar Rudberg, a scholarship student at Hillerska, and the two begin their slow, torturous burn into the show's central homosexual hidden relationship. Unlike its more fantastical rivals, looking at you, Gossip Girl, the stakes in Young Royals feels genuine. Perhaps it's the casting of actual youths or the tangible conflict between love and royal duty, but the embers of youth have never been more appealing. Number 3. My Name. My Name focuses on the life of Yoon Ji-woo, a high school girl who is forced to face with the consequences of her father's mafia lifestyle. Ji-woo's father is murdered on her birthday, prompting her to seek vengeance. Ji-woo, seeking advice from a crime lord, adopts a new identity and joins the police force in order to discover the person guilty for her father's murder. My Name isn't afraid of bloody combat scenes or gruesome murders, so go into this series expecting the worst. If you made it through Squid Game, you should have no trouble observing Ji-woo throw a few punches. Number 2. Maid. Maid employs a needlepoint brush to strike agonizing accuracy. In this horrific miniseries, a young mother, Alex, Margaret Qualley, leaves an abusive relationship with her 3-year-old daughter Maddie in the middle of the night. From there, Alex experiences homelessness, custody fights, limited cash, her mother's persistent manipulation, and failing public aid programs in a true American story. Maid, based on Stephanie Land's best-selling novel, Maid, Hard Work, Low Pay, and A Mother's Will to Survive, will make you weep. Sad tears, frustrated tears, glad tears, all of the above. But it will not leave you feeling hopeless. Number 1. Squid Game. The show of 2021 was Squid Game. In truth, the internet is still stuck in the Squid Game era. You've probably heard of it if you're a living, breathing entity. If not, take a look at your pulse. The nihilistic, record-breaking South Korean series has apparently been seen by 142 million households, making it Netflix's biggest hit to date. Squid Game's stark critique of capitalism and how it erodes humanity resonated with audiences all over the world, owing to its deep roots in Korean history. And its ubiquity has propelled its performers, the venerable Lee Jung-jae and acting rookie Ho Yong-jung, into the international spotlight. It's done what few shows can in the streaming era, it's kept our attention. So, which is your favorite Netflix series in 2021? Let us know in the comment section down below. So, that's a wrap of the video. Please subscribe to Best 10 Vids for more videos like this. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.